Let's talk politics with Michelle Malkin, who joins us every week this time. She's out in Colorado Springs. Michelle, we got to start with what is being referred to by the tabloids here in New York as Wienergate. Yesterday, he admitted he did not send it, but he couldn't say whether or not that lewd image was of himself.
Yeah, so it may or may not be his package, but he doesn't know if in fact, he delivered it. And I think that the more he opens his mouth, the deeper the hole is that he's digging here. And it's really causing much consternation now among his own party and party insiders. He's not being well served by his staff or his advisors or his ego, for that matter. And I think the more that he deflects, the more that he creates hostility with the liberal members of the press who have been such allies of his over the course of his political career, the worse it gets for him.
All right. So yesterday he did this barrage of interviews, and you would think that that would have cleared things up. But instead, some people are saying it made it worse. I don't know. You listen, Michelle, and let me know what you think.
Is this Twitter picture in question a picture of you?
Well, let's remember this Twitter picture in question is a hack or a prank that someone posted on my Twitter page with someone else's name in it who says she never got it and doesn't know me and I don't know her.
You definitively didn't send it, but you can't definitively say whether it's you or not.
I can definitively say that I did not send this. I can definitively say it looks a lot like a prank and a joke about my name. I can say with certitude that I have hired someone who is going to come in, deconstruct this as best they can to make sure this doesn't happen again.
Sure. My Twitter feed says this from one guy. Just put this in. I put out that I was having this interview with you, and here's what he said. Quote, seriously, how does at Rep Weiner not know what his own drawers look like? That was the question.
Fair enough.
I mean,
I've tried to answer that for you several times. I appreciate it, though. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Now, Michelle, we did an unofficial poll here amongst the Brian and Steve and the crew, which all happens to be men at this point. They all said that without doubt they would be able to know their drawers.
Pridefully.
Sure.
I've seen them a million times. They're in the drawer every morning.
I can tell you I can identify my pelvis in a lineup.
Their drawers on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Good to know, and it doesn't take some sort of high-level CSI-type forensics to know, which raises a couple of questions. One being, how many other pictures might there be like this that would cause someone not to know whether definitively with certitude that these are his? And I think more seriously, of course, there are other people who would know, and those are people who Anthony Weiner is going to have to answer to. Primarily his wife, of course, who in some of these interviews yesterday he shamelessly used as a human shield. And I think, I mean, that's the bottom line here. As much fun as so many people are having, this is going to have a human toll on his marriage, and it's probably one of the most candid things he said yesterday, worrying in public about whether he's going to survive the first anniversary of that marriage. And ultimately, I think what he needs to do is reassess this strategy of being so combative, arrogant, and continuing to say that we should move on while his mouth continues to run and not answer direct questions.